Hi everyone, Jeff from Outdoors in the Low Countries. Now, as you might see, this tractor has a 3-point hitch at the front side. Let me illustrate you. Now, this 3-point hitch is very handy because you can connect a lot of implements to it, and together with the hydraulic valves, you can do a lot of interesting things with it, like a front rotating brush, a weed brush, but also a front flail mower. And in many cases, the way that you connect an implement with this 3-point hitch at the front side is with an A-frame. Now, this is the Kubota original A-frame, which you can connect towards the front side. And this way you can easily pick up an implement. But if you now want to also have an extra balance weight on the front side, you have to do something different. Now, the new model of the weight balance carrier is this one, which I could of course connect towards this internal A-frame. But now I have an issue, because this is a Kubota weight that I still have from my previous Kubota, the B1600DT, and that simply doesn't fit. Because there's another interface between the weight and the carrier. So how are we going to solve that? So I solved that by welding the old weight carrier onto a external A-frame. So that fits over the A-frame like this. You can then also fixate it with the bolt connection, that's the Kubota system, and now connect the weight to it. And as you can see, that fits. Now, because of the front 3-point hitch together with the external A-frame, the weights are quite towards the front, giving an extra distance towards the tractor and thereby giving an extra moment, so making the balance weight extra effective. So this is great, so I can now put my front weights onto the Kubota for doing some heavy work at the back. But sometimes you also want to have a weight at the back, for example for some loader work. You then could say, take off this front A-frame and put it at the back. This is a category 0 A-frame and you could mount it towards the back. The problem, however, is that this pen of the top link is 20 mm and the standard top link pen is 90 mm. So this pen doesn't go through this top link. You could of course also put a smaller pen through with this top link and then still mount it at the back. But then I need to remove every time this top link construction. So that's why I choose for another option. I decided to make a backside internal A-frame. Now this is made from old materials that I had lying around. For example, this part, when you look carefully, was in between the ropes, which I shortened, and this was what I had still left over from this ROPS profile. So I used it for an internal A-frame at the backside. Same with this one. This was an old beam for having the trailer connected. So also that I used. So I can connect this A-frame to its rear 3-point hitch. And I can use the same weight carrier also at the backside and fixate it with the bolt construction. And so I can use my balance weights also at the rear side, using the same frame. So with this front side A-frame weight carrier and the rear A-frame, I can mount my weights at the front as well as on the back. And in this video I will show you how I've created this using some old materials and an original Kubota weight carrier. So Kubota changed from this type of weight to a new type of weight. Now, of course, I can still mount this one and then buy new weights. But yeah, there's also another alternative. That I use the weight carrier from the previous weights and put that on the new tractor. And that fits. Now, from a previous project, when I reduced the ROPS, I still have these parts lying around. Never throw away this type of material, because you can always, not always, but in many cases you can reuse it. And what's the funny thing? This fits. So this is great. So what I can do,
is to use these materials to create my own A-frame at the back side, which you then can easily mount. So this one will then be for the front side only, and I have a backside A-frame where I use these profiles. And then I can use this both at the front and at the back with the weight carrier. Now the first step is to make sure that we have the right angle of this outer A-frame onto the inner A-frame. And for that I will use this piece of board. So I can put it on top, and with this old material I'm going to screw it exactly at the right angle, and when it fits in this board then I don't have to worry that the angle is a little bit different, because this is exactly the right angle that I need to have. So I want to mount at the bottom side the profile, so I have to make sure that I have some space left between the bottom side of the outer A-frame and this inner A-frame, because then I can mount this profile here, but it doesn't then interfere with the outer A-frame. So that's what I'm trying to do here. And put this one also the right location. And then you see that I need to take out a little piece here of this side in order to make it fit. So that's something that I will cut out with the plasma cutter in order to make both pieces fit together. Now before I weld it off completely, I want to check if it all fits, because it's now easier to take it apart than when it's completely welded. So let's do the test. Oh, that looks very nice, right? So, yeah. That's okay. Fit test passed. Now this is another small piece that I also had left from the ROPS. That's something that I will need to use at the top side, because Kubota has this system to lock it. So I'm going to put this at the top side. Also there use the plasma cutter to make the right shape. And then weld this nut onto it. And then I can fixate it, which of course you want. So I need to cut out this part, so I can put this at the top of the inner A-frame. So now I line it at the top side. The welding magnet is keeping it in place. So I will now put some stitch weldings also here in order to have a proper connection. So now I was thinking, how can I connect my internal A-frame towards a three-point hitch at the backside? Multiple possibilities there, but then I saw this old beam with holes that I used for the old B1600DT for connecting the trailer onto the backside three-point hitch. Now this of course creates a great opportunity to connect it towards the internal A-frame. It's quite heavy, so that also helps in the weight. But also it's very robust and it fits very well towards this internal A-frame. I can just weld it to it and then I have the connection. So I just need to remove this bolt and then I can weld them together. This is a great opportunity. So you see, never throw away old material. It's always useful, well always, but in many cases it's useful to create something new out of that. And that's why I like a strong vise. So the bottom side of the 3-point hitch has now been welded together. It gives a nice fit. So this is very nice. So for the top side link connection, I will use this beam. And I will put it like this, with a piece over here. And then I can mount the top link about this distance. So I need to have, this length. So this is a piece of metal that I used in some other project. You can still see the plasma cutter marks. Used to be an angle profile. So let's use the plasma cutter now and cut it out. So the welding part of the internal A-frame is now done. It's all finished. Next step is now to give it a nice Kubota gray color. And it also sounds fine. This is the weight carrier for the old weights, with the interface towards the old Kubota front side. It doesn't work because I need to weld it onto this part. So I will first now use the laser cutter to remove this section. So let's find out what we need to remove. So this I will cut out using the plasma cutter. And the next step is to weld the weight carrier onto the external A-frame. As you can see already, cleaned out the paint so we have proper welding. Also, there's a very bad painting over here. So this is an original part that came along with the tractor, and you can see how poor the paint job has been done. So I'll also clean out that part and I will repaint it as well, because this also needs to have a new layer of paint because of the welding that will destroy, of course, the original paint. Now all the parts are now properly welded together. Robust weld, don't expect it to fall off during operation. And let's see. Yay! It even fits great on this side. So the next step is now to degrease it and then give it a nice gray color. Now for the painting I will use this paint, Trimetal Styloxine. It prevents corrosion and it's both primer as well as finishing, and it's a very good paint. Bullet in RAL 7012, so that's basalt gray. It looks a little bit like the Kubota gray. A little bit different, but that's fine for this implement. And then I have it all together with a very good paint. So that's what we're going to do next. Now these weights have a hole over here where you can connect them together. And we have this old pin that I found, which fits nicely through the hole. And when I then also weld a ring onto it, I can also put it in and take it out easily. And this way you connect all the weights together making it a better fixation towards the tractor. And of course, giving it a nice Kubota orange color also helps to match with the gray that they already are.
Nice, happy orange Kubota color.
So with this front side A-frame weight carrier and the rear A-frame, I can mount my weights at the front as well as on the back. And even though this frame has clearly been made for 5 weights, there's no way I can get in number 5. There's simply no room. So I need to leave it at 4. And this is an original Kubota weight carrier, so that's not a good thing. Now, in order to fixate them, I also created this pen, which I hope will prevent the weights from falling off. They're clearly fixated much better now, so no problem there. And the nice thing about this extra A-frame at the rear is that then I can also connect other implements that already have this A-frame connection, like for example my transport box, but of course you can also see some other examples on my channel. So I'm now able to connect 4 balance weights towards the weight carrier. Number 5 has to be left out. Sometimes things go different than you have planned. This is an original Kubota weight carrier, so that's a little pity that it doesn't work. But yeah, that's life. Sometimes things go differently than you have planned. Perhaps you will see another video of me where I modify it so number 5 can also be mounted. I don't know yet, but I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.